I was very sure my whole life that I wanted to be a therapist. I did my master's in industrial psychology till I started practicing therapy and realized I no longer want to be a therapist. So there's this very famous stylist called Tanya Ghavri. And when I was so unhappy being a therapist, I was going through 100 different jobs a day wondering what I wanted to do. And she was looking for an intern currently then. And from being a professional therapist, I then decided I wanted to be a styling intern. And I think I gave everybody else a shock of their lives when I said I would go back to being an intern. I went on to doing films soon after that, and then I started interning with Manish Malhotra. I went on to assisting with Manish Malhotra then. And yeah, after that I guess it just kind of worked out. I've never looked back since. It's been just hard work. You have to give up a life. There is no timing, there is no holiday. It looks very glamorous on the outside, and I think it's that much less glamorous when you're styling. We've done 42-hour shifts where I've slept in a box on set. It's been like that. But it's been amazing. I don't think there would be any other profession that would be as exciting as being a stylist if you're passionate about clothes. So I was assisting Manish on this set of ki&ka at that time. And someone was screwing up a tumbin, and they saw me working on ki&ka, and they asked me if I wanted to do tumbin. And I think I was so excited, and I instantly called up Sagrika, who we both work as a team. So when I called her, she was as ecstatic. She was working on Dangal at that time. And we both, I think, grabbed tumbin with, like, we were so excited, we couldn't think beyond that at that point of time. It was a very exciting time when tumbin happened, because that journey from being an assistant to a costume designer had finally come through. So that was great. So when we were styling Neha, there were a lot of considerations. One was that she had to be the girl next door. At the same time, she was a girl who was living in Scotland for the last 10 years or so. So she still had to be a modern girl. Plus, given the weather of Scotland, it was freezing. So we had to be prepared for everything. At the same time, the actor had to be comfortable in that weather, in spite of the fact that she had to look good. So we had a color palette. We were sure we wanted to use candy colors and a little bit of pastels depending on the scene. And I think everything was put around that. So we had a lot of skirts, we had trench coats. We wanted her look to be young, we wanted it to be chic, but at the same time we wanted it to look very pretty and dainty. I think the pink plaid dress for Masta, which was the song in Tumbin, was one of the first outfits that were decided in the entire film. So when we tried it on Neha, Anubhav sir was the director, our EP, Sagar, everybody, Neha itself, the actors, us, we all liked that so much as a look that I think that was one of the first things we finalized, and said this will be for the song. And because it's a short dress, it has that movement, so there is this there's a shot in the song where she's running down on the streets of Edinburgh with about 100 balls run, like, you know, coming after her. And it just all somehow made sense in our head when we saw this dress. We said, this is what we want. So I think sometimes when you see an outfit, you just know that this is the outfit we want to use. And I think that's what happened to the pink plaid dress. It just worked. The sunshine yellow dress was actually chosen because if you see the Scottish weather, it's so gloomy, it's so dark and dingy that we wanted something to pop. And that yellow dress just somehow lifted the entire scene up. And I think that is the beauty of styling. That there's one outfit that can change your entire way you look at a scene. And I think that's what happened to that yellow dress. So it's one of those moments we're very proud of, because we thought that scene looked beautiful because of that sunshine yellow dress. Black and white. 80s, I think 90s was the worst era for fashion. Amitabh Bachchan's belt bottoms, I think they were iconic. Kati Naked. I can picture that blue sari, I think, through my life. Pink. I think Kangana is your next style icon. I think the kind of the saris or the dresses that she carries with such ease and grace, I have not seen anyone else lately do that. I think she is my next style icon. I loved Erdile Mushkil. I thought it was a very, very well-styled film. I think if I wasn't a movie star, I'd be working at an animal shelter. That's the only other thing than clothes I would want to look at every day. Imtiaz Ali. I think I've not seen a better storyteller than him. I would love to work with Imtiaz Ali. Manish Malhotra. Hands down, I don't think, and he's been doing it since the 90s, consistently. Shah Rukh Khan. I think Shah Rukh Khan in just a like a white shirt and jeans also looks so handsome, he doesn't have to do anything more. Shah Rukh Khan, hands down. Alia. Priyanka.